Raider. I just managed to get my halberd to fire halberd to fire halberd plus 5, so the damage is now 396 rather than 286, I think. And my tower kite shield to plus 10, which increased its stability to 69. And now we'll continue on where we left to this walkthrough. I already showed you the way to the rats that you can farm humanity with. Let's kill them as well. The humanity drop chance is also low. If you got some nice, but you shouldn't expect for much. Especially not without the ring that increases your chance to get items. I will show where the ring is, so nothing to worry about. So after going this place, there is a mage mob, which is really crucial to kill in my opinion, because that bastard likes to involve your fight with the boss. You just increase damage of the mobs around. If you want, you can go here to kill some more rats. You don't need to kill them. I am not sure if there is anything. No. You don't need to kill them, especially when they are empowered like this. But you can kill them to try getting immunity. Immunity can be shot like at the beginning of the game. You can try jumping here to get this item and that item. If you want to fight with this rat. This is the mother rat, I suppose. There is an easier way to get here. Oh. Well, it always drops a humanity. Let's drink. If you let him attack you and block and then attack, it will go down much easier than I did. Well, I mean, you wouldn't take any damage. Alright, let's go down from here. And when you go down from here, these basilisks can curse you, so be careful not to get cursed, because curse is really nasty in this game. Ironic, if you ask me, since you're already cursed with undead, undead spell. I say spell, it's not really a spell, is it? Ring of Evil Eye restores HP every time you kill an enemy. Might be worthwhile to use at the beginning of the game, but it's not really for PvP or PvE on that case. So for bosses, I'm not sure if you would ever use it. Someone apparently couldn't take this anymore. Let's kill this one as well. They drop Eye of Death, which can be used to join the Dark Lord Covenant, I think. It's basically for PvP, not PvE. On the other hand, it is a really interesting one. It only, or mostly, works on New Game Plus. If your enemy is on New Game Plus, you can increase the difficulty of the game. By the way, in here you get invaded by an NPC. Nightcrawler. That's talking. Again. His weapon is quite short ranged. And he's heavy, so his dodges are heavy as well. By the way, I get to the point that my dodges are now normal rather than heavy. Let's get his shield and sword. There will be a few more rats. Yeah. Can kill this if you want to have an extra item drop chance. Sorry, shark drop chance. And then open this shortcut to use those valuable souls you just gained to not lose them. I will change my rank back to blue 2 stone. I don't think I will get a good use of it, so I will try to change it when I can. I'm going for full endurance heal till 40, but you can actually try to go same with vitality and endurance to have both HP and stamina high. I like to reach maximum stamina as soon as possible. It helps me with blocking or attacking as much as I want. And now to the boss. Should be one more rat, there it is. Okay, as we killed the magey thing, the mob, there shouldn't be any more stuff troubling me fighting with the boss. You can summon Night Solar here. I will actually summon him to show you how it works. He is most likely to die in this fight. This fight has a lot of damage, but you don't really need your shield at this fight. The boss is really, really heavy, and I will now show you the best way to fight this one. This is the Gaping Dragon. The idea is to get him to do this attack, and when he is on the ground he will not charge. Where he looks, not there. So after you make him drop. And then attack. Alright, he's going to attack with his tail. He usually jumps, I don't know why he didn't jump. Alright, another tail attack. You just need to be careful not to go too much. Okay, now he's focused on Solar. I can simply go to his ult. Okay, got the tail. As I said, Solar is most likely to die, especially if you go for the tail weapon. It's a huge strength attack weapon. Requirement for strength is very, very huge on that one. Just not be close to him when he does that attack. And this should kill Solar. Alright, I will not attack anymore. Oh, he just got up. When he does this attack, he will just make your items go. Lose durability really, really high. Just go away as fast and as far away as possible. Just do not be on his way. I didn't even really need to attack over there. I just did to do an extra damage. This is me being impatient. You shouldn't be impatient in Dark Souls, really. it is a little bit of a mistake. I did it anyway though. Now running away. This should be an item from standard. Standard, I think, is the starting item of Hunter. Should be standard credit rather than anything else. That's a good one. And now I think this will be the final. Yes. Which now gives the Blighttown cave. I will avoid going into the Blighttown. I don't really like this place, but who does? If you have Master Key, like I do, you can easily skip that. Let's increase our endurance a bit more. And now let's go. And since we are not going to Blighttown, well, since I am not going to Blighttown, if you guys wanted, I can make this walkthrough to go through Blighttown, but I want to avoid that place as much as possible. That place is not really beginner friendly at all. Why I get to kill now? I didn't really get anything. Anyway. So let's go. The next area that we plan to go, Blighttown. The boss has huge fire resistance, meaning that our halberds won't do much damage. Bummer. This boss will be the hardest one to kill, but luckily I have myself a Drake Sword. I didn't upgrade it. It should be enough to kill the boss, but with that you need to be careful. You're not going to hit hard. The damage will be low, but you can definitely kill it if you're patient. And since we have the since we have Drake Sword, it is definitely possible to get it. Actually, I decided not to go there first, because there is a chance to get toxic from those mobs. I will get two of that item to be honest. Oh, let's block this one. I will go get myself two blooming purple moss. I just realized that I forgot to show you where to hand in the large ember. So I will also show you. If you don't hand in the large ember and then modify your shield to plus 6, you won't be able to upgrade it to plus 10. Nice plunging attack, a bit lucky. Ah, alright. Okay, let's go. You would do better to use the bonfire there. Although there is not many mobs to kill, maybe two or three. But if you want to be on the safe side, you can always use the bonfire over there and not lose your humanity or not make your way all the way from the last bonfire I was in. I am going to use SS Plus for me to not die, even though I think it's very unlikely. That's bad stuff. The other one you can most ignore. If killed, it's fine. But you can definitely ignore him. Let's go. As you hear the blacksmith, this blacksmith is interested in the large ember. While we are here, I'm going to kindle this flame as well, since I have the souls and I am not going to farm anything at the moment. It is a good idea to kindle this. Now let's go down. And this guy is actually modifying items to plus 6. That's actually not good. Let's put items there. You can also buy an Artorias crest here. No. Let me check the name to say it right. Crest of Artorias. It costs 200k souls. It's quite a big investment early in the game. I bought it and forgot to mention it. But let's go. This mob can easily be ignored and not killed. But so you can just go there and run. Just try to dodge his jump attack if you can. And then go here and you are done. You can't come from here. Let's actually kill it. Let's not get your bonus attacks. This is a slow attack, actually, and luckily he's just in bed. I hope he just does that to you too, so you won't get attacked. But if you keep your shield up as much as possible and try to go to his sights, it shouldn't be too hard to kill. These plants are weak against fire and they might drop the moss I bought, but that moss has a really low chance to get dropped. Ouch. Ah, I'm too far away. Just block him actually. If he does something like that, he wants to grab you with a really slow motion without any whips showing up, then run away from him or kill him as soon as possible. But if you have a fire halberd like I do, you will just one hit them. Let's open this shortcut as well. As you can see, there's a shortcut, and activate this bonfire. Let's kindle them to max as well. If you have the crest of Artorias, you can open the door next to me. I will now show you. I will not open it. It's a PvP area and you are most likely to get invaded there. So if you are in human form, be ready to fight people if you want to go in here from there. If you have the Artorias crest, that is, which is 20k souls. Otherwise you can't get in. But let's go. When you pick this item, the plants will go wake up and want to kill you. As I say, you can easily block them. They are not too hard to block. And let's go through this one. There is a secret way here, this one. This tree is blocking our way to go. There is a ring I want to get, and this, I don't even know what this is, to be honest, is a good way to farm green blossom. Green blossoms increases your stamina regeneration for a limited time. It is really favorite PvE item to use. Stamina can cause a lot of problems if you don't. There is, I need to kill that knight as fast as possible too, but these things will also cause me to. This knight hits hard and has a good block, so be careful with them, they are really slow. If you can go to their sides or back, if you can reach their back, you can backstop them. You can easily take them down, they don't have much HP. Their armor is pretty powerful, but they don't have much HP, so it shouldn't be too much of a problem for you for taking down. As long as you're fighting one by one, there is no problem on taking this guy. So as you can see, if you wait for him to get up and then simply attack him, two-handed it dies with two strikes, one-handed it dies with three strikes. Wolf ring increases your poison, and poison is that mine is, if I can see it I will tell you, 86. When you get attacked, you get an animation that shows you that you're flinched, that you will lose time. Poise is actually help you not to get flinched, because at that animation you also take, I think, 10%, maybe, not sure, I don't want to lie about it, maybe 10% more damage if you are at that animation. So let's go to the next boss before I finish this video as well, after showing you everything I want to show in this area. Okay, this one will get up with... oh, slowed me. But after he dies, the slowing effect goes. Nice. Elite Knight. I think that's a better item, armor, than mine. Let's check. Yes, Elite Knight is slightly better with slightly heavier. Let's use it rather than my knight gear. I can still normal roll. So let's go. This is the area where you go to boss. I will come there just in a little bit. I'm not trying to be greedy to kill things. There are some items probably not worth trying to get them, but I mostly forget getting them. I don't even remember where it is. It should be around somewhere here. Yeah. And this is actually a mob, so be careful. There is a partisan here. Let's get rid of it. Partisan is some kind of a spear. So this is why you get it if you are interested in it. It is, I think, slightly stronger than a normal spear. And less strong than a winged spear. If you are in the human form, you can summon this witch. If you are especially melee like me and have not powerful bow and use bow just for pulls, it's a good idea to summon the witch, as this boss you will see now that mostly flies. She to the boss, it's a butterfly, I like to say she, but you can easily say it. Land sometimes and wait that. This boss is not really that hard. Oh god, with that damage I won't even bother shooting. Hey you, witch, attack. These attacks hurts even though you block. But you still get less damage if you block them. So it's a better idea to do it. But there is a strong attack that it does. Oh, the witch actually damaged him pretty well. And it is going to land. Right. Easy. It was very easy. And we got ourselves butterfly. So won't give too much soul. So let's go upstairs. And this is where you get the ember that increases fate damage and scales with fate, divine ember. Let's go back to the last bonfire I rested. Use some souls I gained. I only need 500 more souls, so I will just try to get that 500 to through souls. Let's go. I'm actually moving to Firelink Shrine to stop the video, but I want to show you one more thing before stopping. Which is, well, actually handing the divine ember to the blacksmith. It's really easy to do, but I will do it anyway before stopping the video. A bit messy. I should be a little bit more careful. Elite armor is actually a reasonable medium armor if you plan to go for normal rolls, not want to use fat roll in case you want to try dodges, but you still don't want to take a lot of damage. Elite knight items are really reasonable medium armor that you can upgrade. I actually like using them, but I will probably try to get more. And this is where you give the divine ember, so that's great. And we are going to Firelink Shrine. Run to Firelink Shrine. about the PK as well. And finally reaching to Firelink Shrine to go to Blighttown from the shortcut that Master gave. There is another shortcut than running from whole Blighttown, but it requires you to kill some dragons, which without a good bow it will take a lot of time. So here guys, thank you for watching. And if you really want me to go through Blighttown, you can always write in the comments. I hope you have a good day and enjoy the video, and hope it managed to help you.